that were in the gutter and were still looking at the stars, the ones that chose to turn their life around. That's what we're all meant to do in this life. That's all our jobs. Our job is to get handed this trauma, handed this setback, handed this adversity, and overcome it. Then we're supposed to pass on the wisdom we gained from this journey of curing our pain to those that are still experiencing that same pain. We know all too well. How is everybody missing this? We're all healers. We're all healers. These aren't problems. These are the gifts. These are the textbooks written in the stars, handed down to you from the universe to push us forward, to strengthen us. Everything you're being handed, you're capable of overcoming. You wouldn't be handed it to you if you weren't. This is to strengthen you. Life is happening for you. A positive individual is not some happy-go-lucky motherfucker. A positive individual is someone who lived in hell and decided not to exist there anymore. I know hell all too well. Live there, the biggest, deepest, most negative hole you could ever live in. But I chose to be positive, so it meant more. If you live in a negative household and you choose to be positive, it means more. If you're born into an overweight family and you choose to track your macros, train, and lift yourself up, it means more. We are all being given these problems. We're all healers. They're not even problems. They're hookups to strengthen us, to put us on our path. In all reality, that trauma you've experienced is your path. It's the opening to your purpose. When we heal these traumas, heal where this pain came from in our life, our path starts to open up. Unhealed trauma blocks intuition. You will not be able to see anything until you take that first initiative step, which is curing what ails you, so then you can pass it on. What else more do you think you're meant to do in this life other than help others cure their pain? You know how debilitating it is. People say all the time, I hear it all the fucking time, the most valuable resource we have is time. Fuck no. Fuck no. Karmic debt teaches you that. The most valuable resource we have as humans is energy, not time. I've had plenty of time, but when my energy was flawed, when my energy was incorrect, that time was of no fucking use. Tell me when you're doing negative shit, you're using your time wisely, or is it proper energy? So what I'm always teaching is to get your energy in line, get your actions in alignment with your higher self, your best self, conscience congruent steps. You know what you need to be doing. I was around all of them. All the bitches, all the blame game fucks, the straight pussies who look tough. I fell victim to that trap. I was it. I was the worst. The biggest thing we can do is call ourselves a bitch. I tell people all the time, someone will try to sign up for my coaching and be a blame game pussy ass bitch. And I'll literally be like, dude, you're a fucking bitch right now. And they'll be like, I can't believe it, Wes. I'm like, what? That's what worked for me. What worked for me was to call myself a bitch. Then we got into action. You're a bitch today. You don't have to be one in 10 fucking minutes, motherfucker. Step the fuck up. Like I said before, a coward is that motherfucker that'll always talk about something that they're never gonna do. How the fuck are you gonna tell your kids to be the best version of themselves that they could be anything if you're not, motherfucker? How the fuck are you going to tell them to live their best life if you're not, motherfucker? I don't get these motherfuckers who don't personify the teaching at all and try to have a word come out their fucking mouth towards something that is pure hypothetical. If it's hypothetical, it's hypocritical, motherfucker. If you haven't done it, you don't even fit it. You shouldn't be talking. You have to speak about what you've done. If you wish to build a brand, if you wish to build yourself, if you wish to build people around you, you have to do what you're teaching at a high level. That's the prerequisite. Guess what the prerequisite for life coaching is? You sucked at life, and now you don't. So you teach people how to go from the bottom to the top. And I was at the very fucking bottom. And I know how to get to the top, and it's energy. You can have all the time in the world, and if you don't know how to use it correctly because your energy's off, because you're not accountable to your rate of vibration, you're not accountable to your positive and negative thoughts, you're not accountable to your positive and negative actions, you will not be able to get anywhere. The motherfuckers who think this shit's a hack, they will not get anywhere. They will get nowhere. In prison, it's all day. People doing negative acts, expecting positive results. It cannot happen. This is a universal truth. And once you realize that you're falling victim to something that has been written in the stars because of your fucking choices, you can make the opposite choice and change it. How do I know? I did it. I'm not talking about something I haven't done. I smashed my goals this year. I smashed my goals. And I want you to smash your goals. How are you going to smash your goals? You're not going to get comfortable. Comfort zone is the killer of dreams. I never get comfortable. Yes, I've smashed my goals. Do you see me losing speed, losing momentum? I put the gas down harder. I still get up at the same time. Didn't change up what worked for me. Biggest problem, people get somewhere and then they change the whole process that got them there instead of adding to it. Once you get some success, you have to self-inflict more adversity, more, because that success will take you down. Success turns into comfort in our modern society. You can't let that comfort sit in. Even when I was in prison, I was weathering myself. The hardest life, making it harder. These dudes were seeking comfort, and I was seeking more work because I was preparing myself to be a father. I wanted to be a father. I wanted to be the husband that could withstand anything. And it's still difficult. It's difficult, but everything must be. Everything must be difficult, and you have to pride yourself in overcoming the fucking difficulties. If you don't pride yourself in overcoming difficulties, then you're looking for more comfort. Now you're looking for regression. Don't you get it? So the only person that's ever going to win is the motherfucker who takes pride in not being pleased, takes pride in doing what's hardest for him, because it means more. Whatever we do that's difficult for us gives us the most pride. I don't care if you got 10 million bucks. I don't care if you got 100. If it's not that hard for you anymore, you have to move on to something that's fucking difficult for you. Magnify your weaknesses. Make sure you're not standing on your strengths, looking for that trophy, telling everyone how fucking good you are because you've been sitting on these strengths for 10, 20, fucking 30 years. Magnify those fucking weaknesses. Those true weak points, which end up all being internal. They end up all being internal. Magnify those internal weaknesses and level the fuck up.